So one of my favorite classes at this wedding photography summer camp of sorts that I used to go to a few years ago was one where you could just sit in on a wedding photographer editing a wedding or a photo shoot or something. They would just put their laptop screen on a projector, and in front of about 50, sometimes 100 people, they would just edit for 2 hours. And you could kind of raise your hand and interject here with a question or two, and they would kind of expand on what they're doing at the moment. But for me, it was super helpful, especially at the time when I, wasn't quite just starting out, but I feel like I was kind of at a point where I was crossing the bridge from sort of a new wedding photographer into someone a little bit more established. And it was really helpful to see what somebody else was doing at a higher level than me, in terms of, better, more efficient ways to use Lightroom, different editing tools and techniques. It was really cool to see, and they're all kind of by watching somebody work live. They're working through their workflow the way that they've, done so for a long time. And there were times where they would real quickly use a tool. I remember the horizon adjustment tool, and they just kind of real quick grabbed it, made their adjustment, and moved on. And the whole class was like, "Whoa, whoa, whoa, wait a second. Stop and go back. Like, what the heck was it that you just did?" And they didn't even realize that what they had done was borderline profound to the majority of the class. The benefit of this to you, hopefully, is something that I might do that I think everyone does. You might not, and you might find helpful. I thought I would just kind of make a video equivalent of that class, and I'm going to start with just editing and showing you how I edit this one elopement that I photographed a week or two ago in Big Sur. Seemed like an easy candidate to kind of present this type of video. I'd been thinking about doing it for a long time, and just I either keep forgetting and in the moment when I'm editing think about it, but I'm already halfway through. So this time I had edited like 6 photos and thought like, oh my gosh, that's right, I meant to do this. This is a great element to kind of practice on. So I'm gonna throw this out there. I hope that it's helpful for you guys in the same way that that class was helpful for me. If you have questions, I know we're not kind of in a live face-to-face classroom setting, but if you have questions, post them in the comment section. It might actually be even more beneficial than live, just because the questions will be there for other people to read and learn from for, years. I just so like some little workflow procedural things. I'm not going to voice over this. It was just, I think it'd be too long, and I don't even know what I would talk about. I'd probably just ramble about things that don't matter much. So I'm just gonna throw on some low-key music here. Feel free to listen to it or while you're watching, or mute it and throw on your own editing playlist or something. But yeah, I did want to draw attention to the upper right-hand corner of the screen. You'll be able to, I don't use a mouse and sliders or a trackpad and sliders. I use software called pFixer, and what it is, it basically lets you customize the mapping of your keyboard. So, for example, D and F, those keys are exposure down and up, like decrease and increase exposure, and A and S are decrease and increase contrast. So what you'll see is in the upper right-hand corner, a little black dialog box, and that will show the keystrokes that I'm making. So it'll show you like contrast +5, +5, or exposure -10, -10, white balance, etc. So you guys can kind of see what I'm doing visually, in addition to just seeing the changes take place on the photo itself. But yeah, this is pretty much real time. I like I said, I had gone through 5 or 6 photos and then remembered that I wanted to do this. So yeah. Hopefully you can find this video helpful. Let me know if you want to see more of them, and hope you enjoy. Hey, so I was looking for some kind of track to put to
this video, and I couldn't find anything great. And then Megan, my lovely wife, reminded me that sometimes I do this thing where I actually listen to recorded sounds of coffee shop, like ambiance and like background noise. There's actually an app for this called Coffivity, Coffivity, and you can pick from like three different types of coffee shop tracks to listen to. And when I'm working alone at home, sometimes it, I don't know, has this weird ability to make me feel like I'm out in a coffee shop, even though I'm totally alone. Anyways, I actually really love editing to it, so I'm just gonna drop some, coffee shop ambiance atmosphere. This track that I found is from a coffee shop in Berlin. I hope that you guys like it.
Damit wir die Säte aufwenden, also hat Rutter schon ein paar Schlüsse, dann ist einfach ein paar Kälte. Thank you. Ich bin an der Seite. Das ist halt, ich glaube, das ist aber ein guter Teil. Thank you. Thank you. Was eigentlich auch immer, man hat eigentlich auch immer da, aber hat keine Lust. Dann scheiden wir, was wir sagen. Okay, alles klar.